today we will be experimenting with new ways to turn solids into liquids. Mom, how can we turn a solid into a liquid?
All right, so what do we need in order to turn those two pieces of ice into liquid?
You need heat.
Okay, so let's think about some different things that would create heat. What could we try?
We could try a hair dryer.
Okay.
We could try hot water. We can even let air do the work and melt it itself.
Just like set it out on the counter?
Yep.
What if we set it outside?
It would melt faster.
Maybe.
Because the sun produces heat.
All right. What's some other things that produce heat? Maybe stick it under a light.
We could use that. Light creates heat.
Okay, or a flashlight. Well, also, too, think about your body produces heat, so you could hold an ice cube in your hand and see how quickly that melts. You could even put it in your mouth and see how quickly that helps.
That would help.
So, the key to this is choose two ways that you want to test to melt your ice cubes. Connor, which ways are we going to try?
Today, we're going to be trying a hair dryer and a hot bowl of water.
Okay. So those are our two ways. We're going to set a timer here, and each of us will test one of the ways, and then we'll get back with you in a little bit and let you know our results and see which one melted faster. We'll be back in a little bit. All right, Connor, you have a hair dryer. I have a hot bowl of water. Which one do you predict will melt faster?
I predict
the bowl of water. Okay. All right. We'll give it a try. I'm going to set the timer.
I got the hair dryer. You got the warm bowl of water.
Get
all
the
water.
We are
at 20 seconds.
Looks like the ice cube is nearly gone.
Oh. Ah. I can feel being hurt.
Maybe turn it down a little bit
and
it's going everywhere now. Bring it up and do it above it.
It's just kept
my bowl. My bowl of water has almost melted this ice cube. It's been almost a minute. Maybe we should have
used the bowl. Yeah,
thank you for doing science with us today.